The next question is from Janani from Singapore. She is asking, what does a conscious birth signify? Does every conscious birth child get enlightened in their birth?
Every conscious birth is beginning of enlightenment. Once the conscious birth happens, enlightenment is not a big journey. It is only a choice. So usually, all the beings with conscious birth enters into enlightenment. If not, they may choose to stay back in that very state and continue to have few more births out of their free will. But any conscious birth being is considered already on the fast track to enlightenment.
The next question is from Ma Nitya Ramya from Singapore. She is asking, Nityanandam, why does a soul take a conscious birth?
By the strong experience of disillusionment of your projection of fear or greed, when the part is strongly hit, it searches, it seeks the source to which it can unload. The strong shock or the hit it received by the disillusionment, when it turns towards the source to unload its stress and the difficulty due to the disillusionment, it suddenly remembers its source. And the moment of remembering your source and coming face to face with the whole, you remember the secret of your birth. As birth does not happen at all, the moment you remember the secret of your birth, whether you change the body or not, you are conscious birth.
The next question is from Jayalakshmi Bernard from Washington, D.C. Nityanandam, Swamiji and others have said that a soul does not enter a body until the first breath is taken at birth, but newborns are said to recognize the sound of their parents' or siblings' voices or recognize music that had been played to them in the womb. Also, when adults do therapeutic processes like rebirthing, they often remember events that happened when they were still in the womb, some trauma or stress that their parents were experiencing, or a comment that the unborn child was unwanted or a mistake, or the pleasure of being in the womb. If the unborn child is just tissue and not a being, how can it remember these things? Thank you.
The unborn's experiences in the womb are the strong part of its biomemory. When it is in the womb of the mother, it is not just bunch of tissue. It experiences the extended life of the mother, but it does not develop the individual identity, which can be the side effect of the jivatma, the individual reflection of the soul. The individual reflection of the soul itself enters only when the child comes out of mother's body. As two individual reflection of the soul cannot exist in one body, only after the separation the individual reflection starts happening in his own body. He remembers whatever was recorded in his biomemory during the period his body was existing as the extension of his mother's life. It is just exchange of life in one body.